The 12th of September, the U.S. government basically announced that there's certain things that can no longer be sold at airports. At the top of the list, knives. So let's try to get this straight. We, as a people, were selling knives at airports. All of us. All of us. And none of us noticed. None of us noticed because if you saw a knife sold at the airport, you probably were like me. You went, well, I must be hallucinating. One too many drinks. Who would fucking sell a knife at an airport? And then you ran to the plane. The FAA didn't say anything. The idiot who runs the store was fucking selling a knife. He didn't even have the common sense. It's got nothing to do with terrorists. You don't sell a knife to somebody who's getting into a confined space where they can drink all they want. And as they're sitting in coach, they're thinking, fuck, I should be in first class. So they have a few more drinks and they get a little angrier. And then at that point, they think they gotta take a piss. And there's a big long line and they're thinking, not anymore. What kind of a person going back to home and hearth, wandering through the airport, stops for a moment and goes, I gotta buy a knife. The kids have a coconut, I'll buy a machete. Safest place to travel from. I did it this year, a few months ago, Macon, Georgia. No place is safer. Unbelievable security. In a waiting room that's this big, they have the equipment there, and there are five people, two of the National Guardsmen, three security people. The most amount of people that can fit in there, and the most amount of people can get in one of those little Buddy Holly fuck planes they got. is 15 people. So there are 15 of us, five security people. I think we got it covered. It's one person for every three people. Son of a bitch. I wish that was a classroom. They looked, they sent all my stuff through. And then, as they do now, they randomly pick someone for a search. And I get picked a fair amount. And it doesn't bother me at all, because they say it's a lottery, and I never win a lottery. So when it happens, I go, woo-hoo! I won, suckers. And they searched my bags, and then I walked to here, where they would take my ticket before I get on the plane, where they have a random search. Yoo-hoo! They did me again. They did it again. No more than 9 feet apart, they looked through my bags twice. That's the safest flight I was on. The son of a bitch, who knows? I might have been trying to blow myself up that day. We went from utterly shitty airport security to sort of shitty airport security. There's been no change in airport security. Airport security at this point is completely psychotic. It has nothing to do with reality. We have never had a lick of common sense. We didn't do shit before, and now we respond like, oh, fuck, we gotta do everything. We're gonna have somebody here who just reads about security while people are going through. And someone will sing a song about it. It's fucking unbelievable. I was in Newark Airport, and I watched as a mother of two, she's traveling with twins. They're 2 years old, okay? And she's alone, and they told her to put her strollers onto the conveyor belt so they could be x-rayed. Why? 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 And I've had arguments and lines with people, and I'm getting this close to some sort of problem. Well, Lewis, we just don't know. Well, yeah, we do know. We know that a mother with twins isn't going to be fucking with anybody. At what point does a mother with twins have time to trundle down to the wood shop and turn the stroller into a weapon, asshole? If the kids looked a little malnourished, I'd buy your fucking theory. And if you got a stroller that's a weapon, figure it out. How long is it going to take a 2-year-old to find it? Look, mommy. You don't fuck with that mother. You get her onto that plane as quickly as possible and make sure those kids are happy, because the only terrorists she's bringing on that plane are those two little fuckers. What's she gonna do? Let's say she's carrying a weapon. Let's say she's got she's carrying something in her bra. At what point is she gonna make this happen? Huh? At what point is she gonna turn to the person sitting next to her and go, "Well, you hold Frankie and you hold Estelle, I gotta go to the cockpit and kick some ass." I was in Omaha, Nebraska, which is Paris compared to Rolla, Missouri. And it was there that I saw an elderly woman, late 70s, weighs about 85, 90 pounds, frail, being pushed through the airport in the airport wheelchair. She was mobile. A lot of the elderly, they take through the airport now, because a lot of the elderly may be mobile, but she was the kind of mobile, if you went like this, she'd fall down. They patted her down. I am not making this up. They patted her down. They patted her legs, and then they patted her bird-like arms. Then they pushed her over and patted her back, because I guess they were searching for a hump where she might have hidden some weaponry. And then, in an extraordinary moment, the gentleman who'd been patting her down brought over the female security guard, who looked like the warden in one of those lesbian prison movies. She patted the bottom of the wheelchair. She patted the woman's ass. And as I watched this, I thought, you know, it's always important. Remember this. Bring rawhide with you. Because when you see something like that, your immediate reaction is, "Hey, you fucking stop it, you fucking morons! Back off. Back the fuck off." But you can't do that, because your journey will end. So you bring the rawhide and you put it in your mouth and you see that and you twitch for a while. And then that works in your favor, because they think you're having a seizure, so they put you at the front of the plane. The two people who patted her down should have been immediately taken away for psychiatric care, because the stress of the job had gotten to them. They'd reached a point where their paranoia had overtaken them. There's no reason that you examine this woman, because the enemy may be unscrupulous, but they are not masters of disguise. Anyone who cannot lift their own bag and put it into the overhead, anybody who can't do that, that's it. You go on board. We don't need to search them. We don't need to search them. We need to search people who might be strong and can pull shit off. That's the deal. That's the deal. They have made us completely nuts. They have won on that level. They have made security crazy on a level that is just stupid. The most amazing one I saw was a woman in a motorized wheelchair. Okay? Can't walk. Can't walk. Can't fucking walk. What's she gonna do? Spit on you? She can't walk. Does she need a sign? She's in a motorized wheelchair. Maybe she should add a sign in 8 different languages. Can't walk. Can't get out of the chair. Impossible. Need help. It'd be one thing if she looked strange. She didn't look strange. It'd be one thing, you know, but she looked literally, she had striking gray hair, a beautiful dress on, wonderful jewelry, very dignified looking. The way I describe her, and it's the only way that I really could figure out to make it very specific, she looked as if Protestantism had sprung from her womb. They x-rayed her bags and said they had to take a closer look, because I guess she had like a nail clipper and would just go berserk. What's she gonna have in the bag? A flamethrower, asshole? It's one thing if she was like in a clown costume and her orange wig was askew and the makeup was all fucked up, you know? And she had a little monkey on her lap and was playing with its balls, okay? Then I'm right with you. Let's go through the bag. Let us check the bag. Okay, no telling what you got. Snakes in there, I don't know. You let her through. The reason you let her through is because if the enemy has actually hired her to work for them, they deserve to win. It's this simple. The machinery in the airports doesn't work. So the whole thing is a moot point. It's an exercise in stupidity. The stuff doesn't work. It never worked. It's not the people. It's not whether the people work for the government. It's all bullshit. The stuff doesn't work. If it worked, we would catch people. I mean, granted, the people thing is kind of important because in Los Angeles the other day, they actually sent a bunch of people through and then they had to close the airport because somebody hadn't turned the metal detector on. Now, that to me is, well, first off, you just take them out back and get a paddle and you spank their ass. You do. You just spank their ass. I'm serious. That's when you give somebody a spanking. And you do it a lot until they're crying. I'm serious. Not in front of people. I don't mean to shame them, but that's fucking you. That's it. That's the first thing. Turn on the shit. That's the first fucking thing. But the stuff doesn't work. The x-ray machine doesn't work. People have argued with me about that. It's bullshit. I don't care. It's got to be really good. It's got to be something that when you put something in there, the thing goes, fuck, look, here it is. Okay? That's what it's got to be. And anything else is bullshit. I've looked at my goddamn bag when it's gone through there, and I've said, son of a bitch, I didn't know I owned a fishing pole. You build a piece of equipment that works. It's that goddamn important. It should have been done before. They don't do it. They build other shit. You know, they build it. They build a thing so that we can watch the war at night. That's what we were doing. We're watching the fucking war at night. It's night, but it's day. That's fucking different from spring and fall. If you can turn night into day, don't tell me you can't figure this out. You're full of shit. Don't tell me if that in my lifetime, I went from a rotary phone that is so big and so heavy that if a puma came at me, I could kill it. And now they got a cell phone that's half the size of this, and apparently when you shove it up your ass, a fax comes out. So they can build it. The metal detectors don't work either. I know that. The metal detectors don't work at all. I know that because I go through the metal detector. And then they say, oh, we're going to have to check you. Well, I went through the metal detector. That should be it. But then they need to check you again. Well, then that means that doesn't fucking work, does it? All right? So then they got a thing called a wand, and it's the same thing. It's like a metal detector in your hand. And they go, woo. And they do that, and then I'm clear. And then they say, now we're going to have to pat you down. Well, then that fucking thing didn't work either, did it? And if what you really need to do is pat us down, then pat us down. Pat us the fuck down. Don't do this bullshit. Don't send me through two fake things that don't work. Pat us down. Don't waste the time. Or just have a stick and go, ooga booga, ooga booga.